There you are. Thank you for staying with Citizen TV. You're just in time for the latest news update. Here's what you need to know at this hour. There is a blood shortage in the country, and it appears that the situation may be attributed to actions of certain individuals who are minting money through the blood business. Several counties have reported severe blood shortage, amongst them Nakuru, Machakos, Garissa, and Kisumu. The shortage is so serious that the National Assembly's Health Committee is pushing for establishment of a central blood collection center under an authority or a parastatal, in line with a bill that has already been drafted. We kick off our bulletin with that particular story.
It is at the office of the National CBO Council where these boxes full of blood bags will continue to gather dust due to a disagreement between the council and the Kenya National Blood Transfusion Service. According to the council's president, KNBTS has denied them the chance to conduct a blood drive in Nakuru County that was set to boost the county's blood bank reserve.
Tukakatazo kufanya Nakuru, nebati kwa tufanya tare saba mwisi uchao. Tukandika barua kwa KNBTS kulisa Dr. Fred, Frida, kwa Fedi. Kwamba ni procedure gani isa wanataka tufanya, ndiyo tuweza kuruhusiwa tufanya tamu kwa sababu watu wanakufa.
However, those letters, though bearing the received stamp, have never received any replies. The blood drive in Nakuru was to be the second one after the council had finished a similar drive in Machakos County.
Hakuna procedure tuliambiwa na watu wa KNPTS. Hiyo set right. Pia tukienda tulipomaliza Machakos tulienda Nakuru tukafanya meeting na mkubwa huko. Hakutupatia any procedure. Tulipanga na yeye akasema hiyo Saturday tarehe 7 ndio siku nzuri na akasema anahitaji sana damu.
The Kenya National Blood Transfusion Service, KNBTS, has been Kenya's only blood bank, collecting, testing, processing and distributing blood and blood products to all transfusing hospitals in Kenya. But following the withdrawal of the US government's PEPFAR funding, the blood bank has been running dry. According to an insider in one of the referral hospitals in the country, since the withdrawal of the PEPFAR funding, there have been no reagents, tubes or blood bags, all basics of blood donation. Additionally, it has also provided an opportunity for individuals to mint money by pushing blood in certain hospitals, leaving those that cannot be able to fund the need lose out on ever having any blood reserve despite the demand. A pint of blood may cost between 6,000 to 17,000 shillings. Felix Juma is one among many Kenyans who have had to survive their deteriorating health after he missed out on blood transfusion at the Kenyatta National Hospital.
Wakaniambia awana blood by that time, awana blood kwa bank yao. So I love to donate, ni donatiwe damu. So two people came from Mushago and nikapata mmoja kutoka huko. So they were a total of three. Wakatoa damu. After kutoa damu, hiyo damu sikupatiwa. Nilijaribu kufuatilia but hakuna information kwa napatiwa ya maana. They keep twisting me like this. Tuende huku, tuende huku. Paka mwishoe nikachoka, nikaomba discharge.
The incident made him tear apart his blood transfusion card, saying there was no need for him to continue donating blood if at all he could not access it when he was in need. At the moment, a bill proposing to have the Kenya National Blood Transfusion Service get its funding from the Exchequer is said to be facing a lot of opposition. This, as it will reportedly curtail the side dealings of individuals. But as it stands, the blood shortage in the country is severe. Raquel Muigai, Citizen TV.